I'm getting ready to post the rest of the videos that I shot at Mobile Beat this year, but I did want to discuss the CDJ show and Mobile Beat 2017 real quick before I did that. I know I did a vlog earlier, but I wanted to do another one because I got a few things on my mind. Now, I was able to present at the CDJ show, and that was kind of my purpose there. I was pretty busy. I also did some broadcasts. I didn't have a lot of time to hang, which is unfortunate. Next year, if I go to the show, I want to make sure that I do that presentation for an hour, and then the rest of the time is free form where I can talk to people, because that's what I enjoy about these shows, is meeting people and hearing their stories and even getting feedback about what I do so I can better service you all with my videos. When I do my presentations, and I don't call them seminars or lectures because that's not what they are. When I was in school, if there was an instructor that just talked for an hour solid, I tune him out after about 5 or 10 minutes. There was nothing I could do with that. I couldn't interject. I couldn't ask questions. They'd lose me. So I try to have the same type of, I guess, empathy for my audience. And I assume people feel the way I do. I constantly pause for questions after my topics. And then I only talk for about a half hour total. I'll leave the last half hour for open Q&A. It doesn't necessarily have to pertain to the topic of the seminar. We can talk about anything you want, and I learn so much that way. It gives me direction. I don't attend seminars for that reason, because people tend to lecture and don't leave room for questions. But anyway, I get the same thing when I talk to people at the shows. I get so much good direction. Sometimes I'll shoot a video, and I'll look at the views on it, and I'll look at the likes and the dislikes, and I'll think, you know what? That wasn't a very successful video. Maybe I shouldn't talk about that kind of stuff anymore. Maybe I should focus on this other stuff that gets tons of likes. Here's the thing. Some of the videos that I'm thinking were failures were actually a success. Somebody got something out of it. Now, that person may not have a YouTube account, so they can't like or dislike it or comment on it, but they've seen it and it's helped them. That's what I want to do, is help. That's all I want to do, is help. So, yeah, this is great direction. When you look at the likes and dislikes on this video on YouTube, this very video, after it's been up for a day or two, you're going to see dislikes. They always get them. Sometimes I get dislikes immediately when I post a video, before the person even has time to watch the video. So I know they just don't like me, and there's nothing I can do about it. And that's okay. Not everybody has to like me. What I don't do is look at those dislikes, or what I shouldn't do, I guess, is look at those dislikes and worry too much about them. Because what they haven't done is said anything in the comment section about what they didn't like about the video. They just don't like me, I guess. If they don't like something about the video, or they'd like me to do something different, they'll let me know. If I see this as something that I can improve on, I typically try to. That's cool. But just a dislike, I thank you for the view, but it hasn't affected me one way or the other. I don't get upset about it. I just expect it. In fact, if someone doesn't dislike my video, I worry about my haters. Are they okay? Did they get in a car accident? Did something happen? Anyway, I've got better focus now since I've done these shows. Now, unfortunately, I come home and I'm loaded up with stuff that I have to do, both personal and business. So I'm not able to get on these videos as quick as I want to, but they're coming. I've got direction, and I'm happy about that. And I've learned so much from everybody at these shows. It's really been a great experience. And again, I don't attend the seminars. It's all about meeting people in the halls and having conversations. Not the lectures I get from people. I get lectures too. People corner me and just talk to me for 30 minutes, and it drives me nuts. I can't even get them to stop long enough for me to say anything back to them. I tune them out. I can't help it, I do. But if someone approaches me and we have a conversation, that's very different. And I always learn from that. So thank you. Anyone who attended the show, anybody who watches the videos, even if you're disliking the videos, thank you. Thanks for your views. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for a whole bunch of videos. Okay, maybe that's overpromising. Stay tuned for a few videos that I took at Mobile Beat that I'm going to go ahead and post today. We'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Practice and enjoy.